In this video, I'll write a program which gets from the user a timestamp and returns the frame corresponding to that timestamp in a video. A timestamp could look something like this. For example, 00 for hours, 06 for minutes, 7.87 for seconds. So we want the time frame at that timestamp in a video. Let's do this. I import OpenCV and I create a video object using that video file. So it's a short 3-second video. 1, 2, and 3 seconds. Right, then I'm extracting the number of frames here. So how many frames does the video have? And how many frames are there per second? We want these two variables, these two numbers. And I'll explain you why I need them. So let's run this to see what we get. Yeah, so number of frames is 90 and FPS, so frame per second, is 30. So 30 times 3 seconds, we get 90 frames in total. And these are properties of OpenCV to give us the total number of frames when we use this get method and the frames per second. Again, when we use the get method. So ways to get information about the video. What do we do with these numbers now? So the idea is that, for example, if we had a timestamp such as 00 hours and 00 minutes and 02 seconds, then we want to calculate what frame is at this particular timestamp. Is it the 31st frame, the 32nd frame, the 60th frame perhaps? So if it was 1 second, we know that in 1 second we have 30 frames. So at the 00 seconds we have the first frame. At the 01 second we have the 30th frame. So in 1 second we have 30 frames. Therefore, at this particular timestamp we have the 30th frame. We have the 60th frame at this particular timestamp. So after 2 seconds we have 60 frames. So basically we want to extract the frame, the number of frame for a timestamp. And of course we can also do this with decimal seconds such as 89. We have to divide by the number of frames per second and so on. So let's do this. Let me show you what I think the formula should be. So first I want to create a string that represents a timestamp. Later on we're going to get this as input, as an input function through the command line from the user, but for now as we develop the program let's just have it here. So 00 for hours, 00 for minutes, I'm going to say 02.75 for seconds. So I'm not using minutes here because it's a very short video. So 02.67 should be within the limits of our particular video file. Once we have this string, we want to find a way to extract any of these members as a separate variable. So first what I'll do is I'll convert these into a list. Timestamp list equal to timestamp dot split. With split, what you get is a list out of a string. Oh, let me print it out. So now we have the items each separated as an individual object, so as a string now. We could go further and convert them. So let's create another variable, floats, that is equal to this list comprehension. So we want to convert each of those items. So float I for I in timestamp list. And see that this time, this list will have floats. You see, these are in quotes, but now we have them as floats, as numbers, and that allows us to make calculations. I'd go even further and store each of these items in a variable. So let's say hours, minutes and seconds equal to timestamp list floats. If you do that, and you can then extract each of the items. So 00, you get the hours. And if I add minutes here, minutes is also 00. So 00 for hours, 00 for minutes. And again, we also get seconds, which is 2.75. So we have the timestamp as numbers. Now we want to get the frame number at that particular timestamp. How to do that? Well, let's say frame number is equal to, so hours, if you do hours multiplied by 3600, you get the number of seconds in hour. So for example, 1 hour has 3600 seconds, 2 hours will have 7200 seconds. And therefore, if we also multiply this by FPS, we get something like, let's say if we have 2 hours times 3600, we get 7200 times 30, we get the number of frames in 2 hours, or in 7200 seconds, in other words. So after 2 hours, we would encounter the frame number 216,000, right? And then we say plus minutes times 60 seconds in a minute times FPS. And finally, plus seconds times FPS. And that's the complete formula. So that will give us the number of that frame that is in that particular timestamp. Using that frame number, we can use video.set. So video is that object which contains the video file. This gets as argument the property ID, which is 1. With 1, you are saying that you want to set the video at a particular frame. So this is a code for a property. And what is that frame number? It is frame number, this value here. So basically what we're doing here is we open the video, but we don't play it. So we don't read the frames. We read the frames after we have set the starting point. So the starting point is this frame, which is something like, it depends on the timestamp. It will be something like the 60th or 70th or 80th frame of the video. So with 2 seconds, we have 60 frames. And with 2.75, we should have around 70, 75. Yep. So we set that the starting point of that particular frame, and then we can apply that success frame to variables which will be populated with values from this method. So success will get a boolean, such as true or false, if there is a frame at that particular point, and frame will be the actual frame object, a NumPy array representing the image of that video timestamp. And finally, we say cv2.im, right, and we give the name to the frame file, the image file actually. So I'm going to do something like an fstring frame at, we could enter here the hours and the minutes and the seconds. So these three variables. And lastly .jpg, and the second argument, so that is the first argument, the string representing the file name. The second argument should be the actual frame object, which is frame. So this one goes here. Execute. And we have an image. So that is the frame. If you want to further improve the name of the file, perhaps you want to use some other variables here, which you can get from this object. So the time list, if you print the time list, timestamp list, you get this format. You see, with double zeros. So we could get then HH MMSS equal to timestamp list, and then use HH here, MM and SS. Run. And that is the next frame we got. It's the same frame, of course, but with a different name. And of course, you could then enter an input function here instead of having a static string. We could say input enter time stamp in HH MM SS format. So we let the user enter a timestamp. You see the command line asks us, so let's say 00 for minutes and 02.22 for seconds, and we get that new frame. And that is the complete code for this video. Thanks a lot for following this, and I'll see you in the next one.